It looks like a movie scene. Fireballs falling from the roof, explosions going off, inmates shielding themselves just to survive. But it's not special effects. It played out in real life.
Once you have the fires going, you know, that is a very dangerous situation.
This all happening at the Cheyenne unit of the Yuma State Prison back in March. One inmate shot dead, nearly 30 other inmates and 10 prison staff members needing immediate medical attention. So what led to the violent chaos? According to the Arizona Department of Corrections report, a drunk inmate became unruly and refused to follow directions, then began assaulting the officers. That's when other inmates joined in and started to assault the staff too.
This is a very tense situation, of course.
But according to the report, the source of anger seems to come from banning their booze. The report shows homemade alcohol was a problem within the unit. Over the course of 6 months, prison staff removed nearly 120 gallons of it. The assessment showed while there was no single cause of the riot, they found excessive lockdowns and yard closures impacted the inmates' ability to make and possess their homemade alcohol and felt disrespected by the prison staff.
When you work inside a prison, there may be 10 or 20 officers looking after 200, 300, or 400 men or women. So officers are absolutely outnumbered.
But not all fault lies with the inmates. The report and surveillance video also shows 6 correctional officers intentionally destroying inmate property after the riot, including 145 personal TVs, food, and other belongings. Those officers were fired. The report also shows staff admitted to having prior knowledge that inmates were planning to riot after receiving a letter from them, but the staff took no action to stop it. Brianna Whitney for Arizona's Family.